The third aspect of complex adaptive system, or the third keyword, is systems. So we need to understand system approach ka matlab exactly hai kya. Pehli baat jo hum samajhna chahenge wo ye hai ki system real mein hota kya. System is a group of entities which have a real or imaginary boundary. Yani unko agar humne dekhna ho, measure karna ho, to ya unko evaluate karna ho, to clearly pata chale ke wo boundaries ke saath hai. And what does that mean? That means kisko pata chale? Meaning observer ko pata chale. And who is the observer? Somebody who is intelligent enough to figure out this is a system. Now, interestingly, a jellyfish, there are jellyfish jinke andar brain nahi hota, bahut thode se neurons hote hain, and they still behave intelligently. And then there is the case of small singular cellular animals or plants, or for example, let's take the example of amoeba. Amoeba is a cell, or wo uske andar koi brain nahi, still it moves away from danger, it moves towards when there's something which is of interest or food. So it still behaves as a system. So what does that mean? That means ki hum limit nahi kar sakte intelligence ko ya level ko to a system. Now ek aur baat zehen mein hone ki zarurat hai, wo ye hai ki systems can be made up of other systems. Systems can overlap with other system. Systems can be hierarchical, tree ki format mein ho sakte hain. So take an example of life. Human beings are made up of many systems. They are talking with each other. Circulatory system or complex adaptive system, the respiratory system, complex adaptive system, the neurological system, all these systems are working, the digestive system, they are all working together to make this human being. And then the air that we breathe in connects us with this earth, which is another system. Plants and earth, they work together with us. So all the living beings on this planet, and even the non-living beings, they are working on this planet in some way. Then humans form society. At the lowest level, the cells talk with each other. They form clots. They form everything that we are made up of. These are all examples of hierarchical and interconnected systems. Now, one thing which is important in systems is the whole versus the parts. What does that mean? It means that the sum of the parts may not be the same as the whole. So like 1 plus 1 is equal to 2 implies ke we understand what is a 1. Hame pata hai 1 kya cheez hai, dusra 1 kya cheez hai, dono plus sign ka kya matlab hai, equal sign ka kya matlab hai, aur 2 ka kya matlab hai. On the other hand, agar 1 plus 1 hum systems ki baat kare, to we don't really know ke uska result kya aayega. That's why it's called the whole versus the part. The whole can be more than the parts, or less, as the case may be. This is the same as the reductionist versus the holist approach. The whole approach says the human being, that's the whole system, or the society, this is the holistic approach or system approach. Reductionist says, let's talk about only the individual. They don't talk about the interaction of the individual, even though it is a part of the individual itself. So that is the hallmark of systems approach. Where we have learned about complex adaptive systems, and especially we talked about the systems approach, humne dekha ki systems approach holistic approach hai. इसके थ्रू हम ऐसी बातें करते हैं जिसके अंदर होल को लेकर आते हैं, सब चीजों को मिला के लेके आते हैं। हम इंडिविजुअल एलिमेंट्स को इग्नोर करते हैं, लेकिन मेनली हम सोचते हैं कि उन एलिमेंट्स का आपस में इंटरेक्शन क्या हुआ जिसकी वजह से एक इमरजेंट बिहेवियर आपके सिस्टम में नजर आना शुरू हुआ।